This talk is about algebra of graphics, which is the next design iteration of StatsMacie for Macie-based data visualizations and analysis in Julia. The goal of this package is to be able to create a rich, but at the same time modular language to build visualization starting from your data. And the overall plan is to start with a set of custom types that when combined together would encode the specification of your plot. And then given two of these specifications, you can either merge them together, combining information using the times operation, or you can use plus to add them as separate layers, basically to be plotted one on top of each other. The approach that I've taken is heavily inspired from grammar graphics. So the first components are somewhat natural. So first of all, you would need to have a type to encode the dataset. So here we will use the Iris dataset, which is a standard example. And then with style, you would signal what are the columns that you're gonna use. So in this example plot, I'm calling style with the sepal length, which will be our X coordinate, and sepal width, which will be instead on the Y axis. And we will color this plot by another variable called species. And then the data independent part is that it's a scatter plot. So I simply say that spec is a scatter. Then basically once I multiply all these things together, I get my plot specification, which I can then draw. The final ingredient that I'm gonna use is an analysis. So basically sometimes I don't want to just plot the raw data, but I want to do some processing to the data first. And this can be made to fit nicely into the framework. So basically here to make a density plot, for example, I would proceed as before where I select basically the columns that I'm gonna use. I select the data independent part. And then I say that, you know, not only it's the data set and the columns, and the geometry, but also I will perform some processing by this analysis. So when I draw this, it will compute the density of this column and then plot it. As I had mentioned before, I think it's important to have two distinct ways to separate and combine together these ingredients. Because on the one hand, before we create the specification by multiplying simple things like style or the spec, or the analysis, but here I'm using plus to add them on top of each other. For example, this geometry is in some sense a composite geometry, which is sum of two simpler things. So there's not only a scatter, but also a linear regression, which has its own private specification. So for example, in customizing the line width. To sum up the overall design of the strategy, we have four key ingredients: the data for the dataset, the style on how to associate variables to plot variables, the spec to give data independent details, and the analysis to transform data before you plot it. And then with the product, you form a specification, which as far as I understand in classical grammar graphics, you would call a layer. And then with product, you can merge these again to combine the information. And once you have a list of specifications, so basically a set of layers, you concatenate several of these lists with a plus. And finally, a different way of combining two of these lists is with the product, which for the more mathematically minded should really be a tensor product that, create this list of pairwise products. So has basically as many layers as the product of the two lists, and each of them is a merged versions of the two. So for example, given this framework, I think that the easier way to make a user interface is by making a list of dropdowns for basically all the things you could select. And then you multiply together all those dropdowns for which the user selected the non-default value. So here, for example, I made a density plot, but now I can change the plot type and I make a scatter plot with the same variables. And I can then decide to pick a specific variable to split it. And I get this nice grouping. And then I can decide to keep this plot as is and do on top of it a linear regression, and with this kind of multiplication trick, I can basically decide whether I want to keep the grouping or not. So for example, in this case, I have decided that the grouping by color only belong to the first addend of the sum, but does not belong to the linear regression. So I wanna color by species in the scatter, but do the regression with all the data. The tabular data is one context that we have used so far, but it's only one of many. For example, another natural data structure in Julia are multidimensional arrays. And somehow I think it should be easy to plot starting from those as well, just like plots does. And here, for example, the keyword dims create a novel plotting context where the key data is no longer tables, but arrays that are combined together with broadcast semantics. And every element of the array is a trace. And then I can do pretty much as before. So I can define some parameters, some things that are shared, like the x-axis I want to be the same throughout, which I will be able to with the broadcast semantics, the GS is my inverse Gaussians. And then I can choose attributes based on either the first or the second dimension of this matrix. I think that this is interesting, even for those that do work with tables, because you can somehow compose the contexts. So one thing that I found a bit inconvenient to work with in classical grammar graphics frameworks is the so-called wide data, where you want to select kind of many columns at the same time. And the reason why it's straightforward here is that I can do a first pass in this data context where I select my columns, but here I'm selecting them as Julia arrays, which I can then broadcast and then say that for example, the layout on the x-axis will be the first dimension of this array, and then the layout on the y-axis will be the second dimension. And now when I plot it, it will first do the data context and then finish the plot based on the array, giving me this nice, somewhat non-standard wide data facet plot. This is definitely in alpha state. Like, feel free to try. I'd love to get feedback on this, but it clearly needs more cleanup before release. And that's it. Thank you, everybody, for listening.